I've spent a life trying to develop tasks that are good tasks that actually measure what we think they measure. You know, when I think about it, I think the one common factor going through anything that I've ever tried to do is called, I would call, other people have called, the task impurity problem. And that's that no task measures only what you think it measures. It doesn't measure one thing. It all, in cognitive and linguistic, in our kind of research, it measures a whole bunch of things. And trying to find out what all of the contributions of those cognitive and disparate linguistic contributions to that task, even when you narrow it down to almost a trivial task, it's huge. A good task is a task that measures what you want it to measure, but it's hard to know what that is. It's a good task if it measures the thing that you're measuring, that you think you're measuring, without unknown contributions to that task. An example might be a simple sentence comprehension task. So there's a task I've worked on for 40 years. And it seems impossible that we don't understand it yet, but we don't understand it. And it's this simple. When you give people a set of objects and ask them to touch them or manipulate them, and you just say, touch the red circle, what cognitive linguistic mechanisms and constraints does that impose on the system? And then take it the next step, what are the neural mechanisms involved, and what are the lesions that cause impairments to different parts of that? And it's an enormously complex. It involves visual processing and non-linguistic and linguistic and right hemisphere and left hemisphere and words and sentences and syntax, and that sentence isn't loaded with syntax, but the other tasks like it are. It's just huge. And so trying to narrow that down, sometimes with imaging help, I don't think that's proven all that helpful, maybe. And by studying different populations with that task, who has trouble with it and in what ways. Once we can do that, then we know that's a good task. If it is good for this group but not this group, or it reveals something specific about some population that you're interested in, or some cognitive or linguistic process that you're interested in. It didn't answer the question, what's a bad task? But it's a bad task if you don't know what it measures. That's the only bad task. You can become paralyzed by what you don't know, and that's a common doctoral student problem. So we can't be paralyzed by what we don't know, but we always have to be concerned about it. And clinicians probably aren't that concerned about it because they just have to do the work. And when I am faced with actually doing real clinical work, that somebody's life matters what I do with them, rather than an experiment. Experiments, the pressure is off doing experiments compared to what clinicians have to do. So clinicians, you just accept more unknowns. You have to. And that's not just true for speech and language pathology, that's true for neurosurgeons. What they don't know is mind-boggling, given that they're digging around in your brain. But they know enough to be pretty good a lot of the time. So, yeah, you can't be paralyzed by it, that's all. We don't know enough to do anything, but we know enough to do something. I mean, that's sort of the truth.